बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास सिक्स। टुडे इज अवर लेक्चर नंबर 4 ऑफ सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश, एडजेक्टिव एंड इट्स काइंड। एज यू नो दैट वी हैव स्टडीड द पार्ट ऑफ स्पीच एंड इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी हैव डन द टू टाइप ऑफ द टू काइंड ऑफ पार्ट ऑफ स्पीच, नाउन एंड प्रोनाउन। ओके, सो टुडे वी कैन स्टार्ट द थर्ड काइंड ऑफ पार्ट ऑफ स्पीच which is adjective. So in today's lecture we will discuss about the adjective and also its kinds. Okay, first of all, what is adjective? An adjective is a word that used to qualify, modify or describe a noun or pronoun. Okay, for example, if you have a noun or a pronoun, okay, and you want to describe its quality, to modify it, or you want to describe a noun or pronoun, so you can use a adjective. Okay, adjective is used when you want to modify, to qualify, or to describe a noun or a pronoun. Okay, and adjective mean added to, and the meaning of adjective is added to. Okay, class, I again repeat, what is adjective? Adjective is a word which is used to qualify, modify, or describe a noun. It means that, for example, you have a noun or you have a pronoun, okay, and you want to describe a noun, or you want to qualify or modify a noun or pronoun, so you can use the adjective in the sentence. Okay, and the meaning of adjective is added to. So here there is an example of adjective: Ali is the clever boy. For example, I have removed clever, the word clever. Okay, the sentence is Ali is a boy. Okay, Ali is a boy. Ali ek ladka hai. Ali is a boy. So here it cannot describe any quality of a noun. And here the noun is Ali. Okay, here the noun is Ali. So you will see that if I removed the word clever. Okay, for example, if I remove the word clever, so the sentence does not describe the quality, or it does not describe the noun. It is only a sentence. Ali is a boy. Ali ek ladka hai. When I use the word clever, okay, so it means that it describes a noun. It describes the word noun, and the noun here, the noun is Ali. It means it describes the Ali. It describes the quality of Ali. Okay. And the second is, he gave me 5 mangoes. He gave me 5 mangoes. Okay. Here the 5 is an adjective because it describes, it modify it. For example, I remove the word 5. Okay, so he gave me mangoes. How much mangoes? It does not describe it. Okay, so that's why we use the word 5. So it describes a noun. It means that he gave me 5 mangoes. Usne mujhe 5 mangoes diye. So here it describes the he, and here the he is a pronoun. Here the he is a pronoun. Okay, class, I hope you will understand what is adjective. So next, there is a kinds of adjective. First is adjective of quality. Okay, there are 8 kinds of adjective. First is adjective of quality, and also we known as qualitative adjective. Okay, and second is adjective of quantity, and we also called it quantitative adjective, and adjective of numbers. Okay, adjective of numbers, and also here we can also call it numeral objective. Numeral mean numbers. Okay, and the next is interrogative adjective, question marks, interrogative adjective. Next is demonstrative adjective. Next is possessive adjective, participle as adjective, and the proper adjective. I again repeat the kinds of adjective. First is adjective of quality. It describes the quality of adjective. Okay. Second is adjective of quantity. It tells the quantity of adjective. Next is quality of numbers. Okay. In the sentence, the word, the number, describe it. Okay. Then here the number, like in the previous examples, he gave me 5 mangoes. Here the 5 is adjective of number. Okay. Interrogative adjective, question mark, demonstrated, it demonstrated the adjective. Possessive adjective, it used the participle as adjective, and the next is proper adjective. We will describe them in detail one by one. Okay, first is adjective of quality. Adjective of quality. Adjective of quality, in adjective of quality, it describes the quality of any sentence. Okay, describe the quality of a noun. And in quality, the shape, the size, the color, the manner, the thing of a person comes in a quality. Okay, adjective of quality describe the shape, size, color, or manner of a thing or a person. Okay, they describe the nature of or quality. For example, tall, round, long, big, latest, airy. These all are adjective of quality. Okay, in adjective of quality, it describes the shape, size, manner, color, etc. Okay, and it also describes the nature or quality. Example, Akib is a tall boy. Akib is a tall boy. Okay. For example, when you remove, then how can you up kis tarah pehchane ke ki adjective hai nahi? The simplest way that you can remove the word. Okay. For example, I remove the here the word is tall. Okay. When I remove the word tall, the sentence is Akib is a boy. Okay. Akib is a boy. Akib ek ladka hai. Here we cannot describe, we cannot modify, we cannot describe the quality of a Akib. Akib is a noun. Okay, don't forget it. Akib is a noun. Okay, so when we use a word tall, okay, Akib is a tall boy. Akib ek lamba ladka hai. So yeah, so here the tall is a quality of a Akib. Okay, here the tall is a size of a Akib. So here we will describe a whole sentence. We will describe a noun. Okay, this is called adjective of quality. And next is I have a red cup. I have a red cup. So here I have. So remove the red. Okay, remove the word red. I have a cup. Okay, I have a cup. Mere paas ek cup hai. I have a cup. Okay. When you use the word red, white, or any color, so it means that you describe the word that it is a red cup. Okay, you describe its quality. Okay, I hope you will understand the adjective of quality. It is very simple. Okay, next is adjective of quantity. Adjective of quantity. Okay, adjective of quantity show how much a thing is meant. Okay. How much a thing is meant? Like some little, great, sufficient. Okay, it tells the amount. Okay, it tells the amount that some, kuch, little, great, jada, sufficient, jada. So yeah, these all are the quantity of a adjective. Okay, the adjective of quantity tell how much a thing is meant. Like, there is an example, there is a little milk in the jug. Okay, there is a little milk in the jug. Okay, here the little it describes the quantity that it is a very less that the milk is very less in the jug. Okay, it tells the quantity of. Okay, and next is some students are taking interest in their studies. Some students are taking interest in their studies. Okay, for example, when I remove the word some, okay. Then the sentence is students are taking interest in their studies. Then how much student? Okay, how much student are taking some? Yani kuch students hai wo studies mein interest lete hai. Some here describe the amount. Okay, it describe that some kuch students interest lete hai. When I remove the word some, so it does not tell that how much student. Kuch students are a student ya koi student. It does not tell the quantity. Okay, so. Adjective of a quantity tell the amount. Okay, it tell the it you can say that it describe the noun. It tells that how much a student take interest, that how much a milk in the jug is. Okay, next is adjective of number. Adjective of a number. Adjective of a number quantify countable nouns. How many, many, few, five. Okay, countable noun. What is countable noun? Okay, countable noun wo hote hain jinko hum gin sake. Okay, count the noun which we count. Okay, adjective of a number quantify countable noun like how many, many, few, five. So it all these are the countable nouns. Okay, like how many students have brought their English book today? Brought their English book today. How many? Here the how many represent the adjective of a number. Okay, it is the it can quantify a countable noun. Okay, kitne bache English ki book aaj lekar aaya. So it is the amount. How many students? Okay, class. And next is I shall give you 5 gold coins. Okay, I shall give you 5 gold coins. Okay, class. Here the 5. It represents the number amount. 5 is the number. You know that 5 is the number. So when I remove the 5, okay, the sentence remain. The remaining sentence is I shall give you a gold coin. How much gold coins it will give? Okay, here the 5 represent that it will give. 5 gold coins. It gives the number. It gives the adjective of a number. Kind of numeral adjective. There is also a kinds of numeral objective. Okay, adjective of a number you can say. Okay, definite numeral adjective, indefinite numeral objective, and the distributive numeral objective. These three are the kind of numeral objective. What is numeral objective? These are the adjective of a number. Okay. These are the adjective of number. Okay, first is definite numeral adjectives. Indefinite numeral objective, it will tell the fixed amount. Okay, fixed amount like 1, 2, 4, 40, 50, 70. Okay, like first, second, third, fourth. Definite means definite. Hum kya kehte hain? Definite ka ye hota hai mukammal. Okay, it will give a complete. It will a complete number. It will give. Okay. जिसमें मैं एक जरा सा भी शक नहीं रहता. It. That's why we use in most sentence we use a definite numeral objective. Okay. When you use a 1, 2, 3, 4 these number. So these number in definite numeral objective we these numbers we are called cardinals. Okay. We are called cardinals. Okay, and when you use the first, second, third, fourth, fifth, etc, these are called the ordinals. Okay, these are called the ordinals. These are called the ordinals. Okay, and next is indefinite numeral adjective. Indefinite numeral objective, it does not give an exact number. Okay, it does not give the exact number like many, few, kuch, कुछ कितने हमें बताया मैंने, इट डज नॉट गिव अ एग्जैक्ट नंबर, ऑल नो मैनी फ्यू सम सेवरल इट इज द लाइक I will give you an example that there is a 15 students in a class. So here the 15 is a definite numeral objective. Okay, here 15 is a definite numeral objective, and these 15 are also called ordinals. Okay, when I there are some students in the class. So here the sum is an indefinite numeral objective which does not give the exact number. Okay. Next is distributive numeral objectives, which are normally used with singular noun and are used to refer to the member of group as objective. In distributive numeral objective, it will used with the, okay, we can use with a singular noun, only with a singular noun, okay. When a plural noun will come, so we cannot use the distributive numeral objective, and it can also use to refer the member of a group as individual, okay, as individual, like there is a group of 10 students, okay, I will call them one by one by their name. So this is come to the distributive numeral objective. Okay, class, I hope you will understand the kind of numeral objectives. Next is difference. Okay, distributive adjective. Okay, when these words are used after nouns, when these words are used after noun are called distributive adjective. In distributive adjective, we use the words after the noun. Okay, we use the word after the noun, so they are called distributive adjective. Like the example, each boy was giving chocolate to the children. Each boy was giving chocolate to the children. So in this example, the distributive adjective come after a noun. So this is called a distributive objective. So what is distributive pronoun? When a person seems to be distributing the verb or a noun, it can seems to be a distributing the verb or a noun. It's called distributive noun. What is the difference between the distributive adjective and the distributive pronoun? In distributive adjective, the word used after the noun, and in distributive pronoun, the person seems to be distributive after a verb or after a noun. Okay, it's called a distributive pronoun. Like, either Ali or Usman can open this lock. Either Ali or Usman can open this lock. So here we use the distributive noun after a noun. Here the noun is either, so we use it for distributing. We use it like we use the word Ali or Usman, but in the example, in the distributive adjective example, we use only the word boy, okay, and it gives the complete sense, okay. But in distributive noun, we use both the Ali or Usman. We can compare the both thing, okay, class. Next is the most easiest kind of a adjective is interrogative adjective. Interrogative adjective. Okay, a word that modifies a noun by asking question. A word that modifies a noun, which can describe a noun by asking a question, is called interrogative adjective. Okay, a word that modifies a noun by asking a question. Also, we can describe a noun, we can modify a noun, we can differentiate a noun by asking some questions. And in asking, by asking some question, we use some words like what, who, whose, which, where, etc. Okay, Example, whose red scarf was that? Whose? So you see that in the end of this sentence there is a question mark. So it is clearly that this is an interrogative sentence. And in this sentence, the whose, it describes, it modifies a noun, red scarf. Okay, it modifies a noun, red scarf. Okay, next is, which pen do you like more? Which pen do you like more? So here, the which, okay, which, it is an interrogative, you can say it is an interrogative word. It is an interrogative word, and it can describe a pen. Okay, which pen? It can modify a pen. Which pen do you like more? And here the pen is noun. Okay, in interrogative, I again repeat, in interrogative adjective, in interrogative adjective, we use some words. Okay, we use some words to modify a noun by asking some question. To modify a noun by asking some questions. Okay, class, like we use the who, what, whose. These are the words which modify a noun. Okay, there is some difference between an interrogative adjective and interrogative pronoun. Interrogative adjective describe the noun, color, shape, size. Okay, interrogative pronoun. And first of all, I will tell you the difference between the interrogative adjective and interrogative noun. The main difference between the interrogative adjective and the interrogative pronoun is that in the interrogative adjective describe the noun, and you can say that interrogative adjective modify a noun. Okay, and interrogative pronoun does not modify a noun. This is the main difference between the interrogative adjective and interrogative pronoun. Interrogative adjective modify a noun, and interrogative pronoun does not modify a noun. Okay, like example, whose blue shirt is this? So here it describe the blue shirt. Okay, and here the blue shirt is a noun, so it modify a noun. Okay, or you can say that there was a long table in the conference room. There was a whole long table in a conference room. Okay, an interrogative noun, where do you live? So here there is no noun, and we already learned that it does not modify a noun. So in this example, the noun does not come. So it is a simple sentence, where do you live? This is a simple interrogative pronoun, or you can say it is a simple interrogative sentence. Or who are you? Tum kaun ho? Who are you? Here the also the noun will not come. So I hope that you will understand the whole lecture. Today the lecture is very easy about the adjective and its kind. If you have any query, if you have any problem regarding this lecture, you can ask a question. First question is that size is also a quality. Yes, size is also a quality. Okay, it comes to a adjective of quality. Next is uncountable. Those adjective which you can't count. वो एडजेक्टिव जिनको हम काउंट ना कर सको, लाइक योर हेयर्स, आपके बाल, आप उसको कभी भी काउंट नहीं कर सकते. दीज आर कॉल्ड अनकाउंटेबल. ओके, ऑर्डिनल्स. Ordinals, when use this word first, second, third, fourth, when you use this word fifth, okay, in English. So these all words are called ordinals only in a definite numeral objective. Okay. Interrogative pronoun. In the previous lecture, we will discuss them in briefly. What is interrogative pronoun? These are the, you can say that these are questions pronoun, in which the question mark, interrogative mark, comes at the end. And in this sentence, the question will ask to you, okay? Numeral adjective को आप adjective of numbers भी कह सकते हो, okay? And there are the three main kinds of numeral adjective. First is definite, okay? In definite numeral adjective, you use the word which describe, or you can say you use the quantity, okay? Like you use the 1, 2, 3, yeah, first, second, you use these words, okay? And next is indefinite numeral objective. It does not give an exact number, like some, few, some, several. These all are come in the indefinite numeral objective. Next is distributive numeral objective. It comes with a singular noun, and it can, for example, you have a group, okay? And I will ask a name one by one, okay? Individually, I will ask a name. So this will come in a distributive numeral objective. And you use these slides to learn the adjective. There is no English grammar notes. Any question? Okay. In chat box you will type a one example of adjective. This is your task. Classics, you have 5 minutes. Type a one example of adjective in the chat box. Quickly type it. Yes, just one example of adjective. The first example which will come in chat box is they live in beautiful house. This is a true example because the hair beautiful represent how it, you can say describe the sentence. So that this is a true example. Good. Next. Next, you can only type the word heavy rain. It's wrong. Again, type the example. And the next example which will come in chat boxes, he take apple. He take apple. This is a wrong example of objective. Here it does not represent any quality or any, as you can say, any, it does not modify a noun or any pronoun. So this is a wrong example. And the next example is this cup is very beautiful. Okay, this is a true example. Yeah, beautiful is a adjective word. Next is she is a nice girl. Okay, true. Here the nice is a adjective. Next is mouse live in a small hole. So the here the small represent the quality. So this is also a true example. Lahore is a large city. This is also a true example. This shop is much nicer. Next is he is a brave man. Okay, brave here represent the quality. It is a cute girl. Okay, true. जी आपकी सिर्फ आज एक ही क्लास है इंग्लिश की. नेक्स्ट क्लास आपकी मंडे को है. ओके, एनी प्रॉब्लम? आई होप यू विल अंडरस्टैंड टुडे लेक्चर अबाउट द एडजेक्टिव एंड इट्स काइंड. इफ यू हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम और एनी क्वेरी, यू हैव ओनली 2 मिनट्स टू आस्क. Beauty.